Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart and welcome to a video on my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I make my thumbnails. Now the first thing I'm going to do is go into my emails because I actually have a request here from Daniel Tanner, who is otherwise known as his YouTube name Kasam187, and basically he has asked me to make him a Corinthos Let's Play thumbnails for him. It's a request. I'm going to quickly show you guys here before we get into it. If I go into pictures, YouTube thumbnails, these are all folders I've made for myself, by the way. Requests, and these are all the people I've done requests for in the past. So we have Elite Wolf, we have Heretic Pruder, Corpo the Dutch Gamer, Kasam, Lord Rexasaur, Prussian Prince, Skipper Total War and Snowchill. Lots and lots of different people and YouTubers have had thumbnails from me in the past, and they've all been pretty happy with them, so that's great. And of course, Kasam, as we can see here, we have Colchis, Corinthos, which I've actually made the folder ready and put the images in, but I'll show you where I got them from in a sec. Massilia and Spartacus. So if I click on Spartacus and just open it up for you, there we go. I made that for him, Spartacus. If I go back out of it now as well and show you the other one. So Massilia. This is a Massilia one I've made for him. And finally, if I can go back out of it again, I'll show you Colchis as well. So these are ones I've done for him recently in the past couple of months. And now he wants Corinthos. Now Corinthos is a faction that was recently announced as playable in the new Wrath of Sparta DLC. I won't be playing the DLC because many of other channels are covering the DLC, and plus I haven't got time to buy the DLC and play it. I'm quite busy over the Christmas period with other projects that I have going on. So yeah, definitely check out Kasam187 if you want to see Wrath of Sparta. So this is a shout out to him as I make this video. So this is the Total War wiki. This is where I get my images from. If you click on the faction logo here and copy this logo, if you right click and then go to save picture as, you've got a nice looking HD logo there basically. And then you do the same with this, you click on it, make sure it's big, right click, save picture as, and save it in a location. You've got a nice background image. So they're the two things I want really. And if I quickly go onto the Corinthos folder now, which I've saved them in, as you can see, you've got the flag of Corinthos and you've got the logo. So that we've got them there ready. Now what I've done is, actually I will show you what I've done, I'll come out of this quickly. I've gone to Massilia. Now I've got the template already made. I've made these templates. I've got loads and loads of thumbnails which I've made using similar templates. If I just come out of this and show you some of them, if we go to Total War, and we're gonna go on to Rome 2, we'll show you some of those thumbnails. Let's Play folder. And I've got loads of different ones. So we've got the Aravaki here. Similar kind of thing. You know, we've got the lines across, you've got the faction colours, got a little bit of fade in the background which I've added in myself. And then we've got some other different looking ones. Then we've got a Carthage one by here, so got a red Carthage one with the background, plus we've got another Carthage one here, you know, and I've got my name on it. So I've customized them a little bit as well to make them stand out a bit more. But if we go back now into YouTube thumbnails, and if we go into, where did I put it, requests, Kasam187, Massilia, and then I'm going to open up this is a Photoshop file, PSD file, sorry. Basically what I'm using is Photoshop Elements 11. I got regular Photoshop here. I didn't buy this, I torrented this Photoshop because, you know, it's expensive. But this one I actually bought, Photoshop Elements 11. I might actually delete these ones because I don't need them really. I don't use it often enough, and I find Elements much easier to use and it has a much better interface. So basically what I'm going to show you now, I'm just going to check Fraps quickly. Yep, I got Fraps on, fine, that's great. We're going to go on to the folder, we're going to go on to this. I've saved it at Massilia LP, which stands for Let's Play of course, and this brings up the one which I've made previously. Now as you can see, I've got different layers. Look, I've got a Spartacus layer from before. This is all stuff I've done for Kasam, all of this stuff on the right hand side. Look, I've got Macedon, which I did for my own Let's Play, which I've saved there. And basically I use these as things I can put things on the locations of. So I'm going to delete all these previous layers here, because I don't need them. And it's basically reusing layers which I've already used. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go onto File. I'm going to go onto Open. And then we're going to find the right folder. So it'll be the Requests folder. It'll be under his name, Kasam187, Corinthos. And I'm going to open both of these files. And they will open up now. There we go. I'm going to take the logo. I'm going to drag it on. Drag the logo above the current logo. I'm going to resize it. I'm going to make sure it fits perfectly into place like so, and we'll remove the other layer then from beneath it. And there we go, we got the Corinthos logo. Now we want to put the right spelling in. So it's K-O-R-I-N-T-H-O-S, I believe. That's how they spell it. You can spell it with a C as well, but this is the official spelling in Rome 2. We're going to resize this a little bit, and we're actually going to drag it into place, which I think probably about there would be appropriate. And then we need to get the right background. So what we're going to do, again, we're going to drag a nice little line. We could remove the Total War Rome 2 campaign pack thing, which we'll try it like that to see what it looks like. It should still work pretty fine. I'm going to drag this file now above the other layer, like so, and then we're going to see what it looks like. Now, I'm not too sure about this size at the moment. I got a feeling we may have to download this one again. Yes, we will have to, I think. Let's just go back out of that. Let's delete this layer, actually. We don't need this layer at the moment. We'll try it full size instead. But I think we might have to get the proper size of this one. Let's just try it like that. Drag it into place. And drag it down into place. It doesn't look too bad, actually. Actually, it looks quite nice. And then, of course, we've got to get the colors right as well. So what we need to do, we have blues and yellows. We're going to turn this fade off by here. This gives it a kind of sandy, grainy effect, which I use in some of my thumbnails. What I'll just do is turn that off so you've got a nice clear background. It actually looks quite good with a clear background. I think I might go with a clear background for this one. What we want to do, though, is make sure we got a nice looking logo. So we've got blues and yellows and a little bit of brown on the faction logo. And they're the colors I want to use in this thumbnail for Kassam. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get the color picker tool. I'm going to drop it onto the yellow. I'm going to use the paint bucket tool and I'm going to drop it right on this by here, like so. Okay, right now I want to get Corinthos in blue. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to double click, I'm going to click the color, I'm going to click on the color picker, and what that allows me to do, it gives me the color picker tool. I can just drop it onto the helmet to get the right shade of blue, click OK, click OK again, and we've got Corinthos there. That doesn't look too bad, although I'm still a little bit unhappy. So what I want to do now is get the brown color, because that will look nice on the edges, I think. We'll put them on either side, so we've got the right colors blending in. And of course the font. Now the font doesn't have to be this font, we can change it. What I would recommend is downloading lots of different fonts online. I've got like a Viking font here I downloaded, which would be good in a Attila Total War Let's Play, but not for this one really. As you can see, it doesn't really go well with the logo. We could try some other ones. You could try Postino Standard. That's not a bad one. Works reasonably well. Postino. What one to use for this thumbnail? I don't want it to be over cluttered, so I think Rockwell would be a pretty decent one. Rockwell. I haven't used that one in any of his yet. We'll of course make it a bit bigger so it stands out. But it's probably a bit too big. Let's just drag it smaller and then up slightly. I think that's okay. I'm going to go with the corner to corner thumbnail design as well in this one, because that's the style I've been using in all his thumbnails so far. I don't know about the white background. Maybe check that out with blue. So again, the same thing, color picker tool, get the color, click OK. Oh, click OK there first. Click OK. I don't know. See, it's just basically working out what works and what doesn't work. I think what might be best, actually, if I can do it, is to go back to this one here. Make that color. Yeah, that's much better. The lighter on the darker color definitely works in its favor. We'll keep the brown on the borders, though. I think that will be pretty nice. And it's basically just working out what works and what doesn't work. So we get this kind of beige color. Oh, yes, that looks a lot better. And then, of course, we'll do the same with this as well. Get the right color. Click OK. That looks really nice. I think that looks pretty decent. It could be better. It could be improved upon. Now, the only thing I would say is you can add more stuff into this, obviously. For example, I can change the background color to have it a grainy, give it a grainy effect. For this one, I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to actually go onto the effects menu. Let's just see. We've got faded photo. Now, the one I used in the Aravaki, which I showed you earlier on, that was, I think, if I can find it, wasn't frame, miscellaneous effects. It might have been miscellaneous effects. It wasn't vintage. It was faded, I think. No, it wasn't faded. We're just gonna try out. So we double click, let it load. Okay, that's terrible. We won't use that one. Try this faded one. Oh, we will click cancel. No, we'll click go. We'll click cancel. Double check that we got the layer selected. It sometimes when you go back and forth, it does deselect the layer, so you have to go back onto it, unfortunately. As you can see, that's the sort of effect we got. Nice graded looking background now. And I really like that. That looks pretty decent in my opinion. We could add other stuff as well. I'll quickly show you other stuff which I can add. I might add it in this one yet. I haven't quite decided yet. We're going to open, just gotta remember where I save everything now. Probably Photoshop accessories, blood. I got lots of different blood effects. So we'll go with a blood spatter here, which I got off Google. You can get these off Google. Just type in blood PNG and there's lots of different blood spatter effects you can get. I'm just going to drag this onto the picture here. I'm going to make sure this image is above the folder so you can see the blood. And then I'm just going to drag it like so. We want to tilt it because that's the wrong way at the moment. So we're just going to drag the corners. Put it in the corner like so and then just drag it up. Oh yes, what about that? Doesn't look too bad, does it? It blocks out the kind of watermark on the image. It needs to go above the blue though, I think though. So we're just going to drag it above these three layers. And there we go. What do you think of that, guys? Do you think that's a pretty good thumbnail? I think it's pretty decent. Total War Rome 2 stands out there. The blood looks pretty good and it splashes onto the blue. The color scheme works reasonably well. Corinthos with the number and of course the helmet as well. And that's basically it. So this is the final image. So all I got to do now is go into File, Save As. I'm going to arrow out of this and go onto his folder, go into the Corinthos folder and rename it Corinthos LP. So that now he has a Photoshop file specifically made for this. And all I have to do is go into File, Save As, PNG, and just rename it then. So we just call it LP Part 1. And all I have to do then is just keep doing that. So we save the first part. And that is done. And we double click on this then. We change it from 01 to 02 for a second episode. And exactly the same thing again. You're going to save as PNG. And it's going to rename it PNG2. And there we have it. That is the final product. And that is how you make a thumbnail in Photoshop Elements 11 for Total War YouTubers basically. I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope it's helped you out. By all means, if you want a request like Kasam187 or any of the other YouTubers that I showed at the beginning of this video, drop me a comment, let me know what you're after and we'll see if we can arrange some thumbnails for you. I've been Dragonheart, thank you for watching, until next time, goodbye.